and welcome. Today we are taking a full look at the Nerf Pro Gelfire Nightfall Uproar. We did already look at the original Uproar, but this one brings a new really cool color scheme and glow-in-the-dark features. To get those glow-in-the-dark features, it is $5 more than the original. The blaster includes 10,000 rounds, 5,000 glow-in-the-dark rounds, and 5,000 standard Gelfire rounds, but they are blue, so I guess they're not quite standard. The blaster seems mostly the same. We still have a 400 round capacity and a 150 FPS box claim. Let's jump right in. Included in the box, of course, we have the Nightfall Uproar itself, the 400 round hopper, eye protection, the rounds, which have already been hydrated, so you're not going to see those until later, and the instructions. Now, like the original Uproar, this blaster does require 8 AA batteries. It's still just really unfortunate that the Uproar does not include a rechargeable battery. We should be able to pull this right off. Now with batteries, we should be good to go. Now let's go over the Nightfall Uproar. First off, we have really great plastic quality, a very comfortable grip, a little bit of a thumbhole thing that might annoy some people. We have a single rival style rail on top. Technically, we do have a couple sling mounts. This could be a sling mount, and we have a sling mount up here. The safety is right under the trigger. In the rear position, you are safe, and in the forward position, you are ready to go. Of course, right up here we have the hopper. This is compatible with the other Gelfire hoppers. And if we look right here, we see the main difference between this, besides the paint scheme, and the other Uproar. We have a little UV light that will glow up the rounds. Now let's go outside and put this thing over the chronograph. Alright, here we are outside with the Nightfall Uproar. For this chronograph test, we will be using the included blue standard Gelfire rounds. We are claiming 150 feet per second. 141, 144, 149, 144, 143, and duplicate 143. Like the original Uproar, this blaster does get a little bit shy of the box claim. Not by a whole lot, probably not enough to make a huge difference, but worth noting. I am pretty okay with that performance, but it definitely could be better. Now let's fire some shots downrange. For whatever reason, this Uproar does seem to be feeding a little bit more reliably and consistently when compared to the other Uproar. At least my model. It could be model discrepancy or weather, but I'm definitely happy with the feeding. I'm not even having to shake the blaster. Now before I get into my final thoughts, let's see this thing fire at night with the glow-in-the-dark rounds. So what are my final thoughts on the Nerf Pro Gelfire Nightfall Uproar? So do I prefer this version over the previous one? I definitely do. It's still not the craziest blaster. I definitely think it could be better, but it's certainly not bad. The great thing about this one is that you have that glow-in-the-dark feature. It is $5 more than the original Uproar, but that feature definitely enhances this blaster for me. On a subjective note, I also really dig the paint scheme. It's probably my favorite looking Nerf Pro Gelfire blaster. I'm still annoyed that you don't get a rechargeable battery and you have to feed it with all those AA's, but for $39.99, the blaster does perform pretty well, and if you're looking for a pretty casual, full auto, small gel blaster, the Uproar could definitely be pretty cool. I would say before you buy this blaster, you should check out some other gel blaster companies to see what they offer. But if you do like what you're seeing here, I don't think this is a bad buy by any means. If you are interested in this blaster, I will have the link in my description. Thank you very much for watching. Those were my thoughts on the blaster, but I would love to hear yours. Subscribe for more, have a good one, and happy blasting.